nation would know God. They also were told by the prophets that the kingdom would be glorious. A lion would lie down with a lamb, and children could play in a snake pit, and the whole topography of the planet would be changed, and the Lord would create a river flowing from Jerusalem out to make the desert blossom like a rose. They had all kinds of things in the Old Testament to look to, that there would come the prevailing peace and joy and comfort, the absence of poverty, the absence of sickness, long life. If you die at 100 years, the prophet said, you die as a baby. They knew all of that. And he will destroy this one in the future, totally. But before he destroys it, there will be a fourth ecosystem. In the 1,000-year millennial kingdom to come, life on this earth will change. If somebody dies at 100 years, they die as an infant. The desert will blossom like a rose. Lion will lie down with a lamb. Children will play in a snake pit. That is a totally different ecosystem.
The Lord will do it in the future when he returns to establish the kingdom on earth. And the New Testament teaches that that's a real, actual kingdom. Even Isaiah defines the lion lying down with the lamb and the desert blossoms like a rose. There's a lot of elements that they're physical as well as spiritual. Even Isaiah defines the lion lying down with the lamb. Isaiah defines the lion lying down with the lamb.
All right, here's a 1904 story of the Bible. And Jesus is in the temple when he's 12 years old. His heart was so filled with the worship of the temple, with the words of the scribes or teachers whom he heard. Well, I thought it was the doctors, according to the new quantum effect Bible, but he heard the teachers. All right, guys, one of my subscribers today brought up this point. It's a great point. By the way, this is my 1853 King James Bible, so a really old one. For Matthew 28:20, it says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you alway, even unto the end of the world. Of course, I thought that was always. I am with you always. However, guys, online, I'm using Bible Gateway here, King James Version Online. Let me go down to verse 28 here, if I can find it. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, plural. You guys see that? So maybe they start with the hard copy Bibles first with the changes, then move over to the digital. I'm not sure, guys. Let me know what you think. Strange. They're usually always the same. But the hard copy King James versions I have say alway. And now the digital online version says always. Let me know what you guys think.
132-year-old Bible. Oh, boy. Moses with the new tables of the law? Tables of the law? What happened to tablets?
Hey guys, I'm reading the book of Luke, and I see something that I don't remember ever reading before in my King James Bible that I've had for like about 10 years. It says that Jesus was wearing a gorgeous robe. Like, I don't remember it being gorgeous. I remember it being purple or scarlet. It says, and Herod with his men of war set him at naught and mocked him and arrayed him in a gorgeous robe and sent him again to Pilate. So that seems to be a change. It sounds kind of ridiculous. Anyway, leave your comments down below. Let me know what you guys remember. I never remember reading gorgeous robe ever in my King James Bible that I've had for 8 years. That this is the version that I read my whole life since I've been a believer. This is the King James only. So yeah, very, very odd. That's Luke chapter 23, verse 11.
Nothing like being in the great outdoors. That's a fact. And it's just totally crazy, but you gotta hear me, you gotta hang with me on this one. Okay, everybody's talking about the Mandela effect. This is the craziest thing. Now listen, it's changing stuff. You know, people have talked about like the Berenstain Bears, right? You know, you've heard all of that, and everybody was saying it was spelt with an E, and people were flipping out over geographical changes and all kinds of things and time loops and all this and that. And I was working on a video for CERN, not for CERN, but about CERN, and a book called Clavis Inferni and How That All Relates. And anyway, listen. You just got to stay with me, okay? But I got some proof on how some things have changed. I want to give you all something here. It's just sort of mind-boggling. But everybody's seeing it in, and y'all go check it out. I mean, don't take my word for it. Go study for yourself. But they're saying, you know, people can remember certain logos on cars, or they remember, okay, like for instance, remember the Disney movie Snow White, you know, when she's standing there and she's looking at the mirror and she says, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? Well, it doesn't say that. The Star Wars fans, they say, you know, when Darth Vader looks at him, he says, Luke, I am your father. And it doesn't say that. It says, no, I'm your father. It says, magic mirror on the wall. All of your memories, and the majority of people, not everyone, and depending on your age, as to what you've seen or whatever. Remember Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood? It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Well, it doesn't say that no more. It says in this neighborhood. Things have changed. Now, here's why it's so important that you grasp this. And again, go do the research yourself on the Mandela effect. But check it out. I know Scripture. Okay? I know Scripture. This is a point that I'm trying to make. Now, this is old stuff, okay? Bibles and things like that. I know, going back into the old ones, this one's from 1966. It was a family Bible my mom and dad had had. You're looking, and I'm talking King James. Try and go with the King James Version, okay? Because all these translations and stuff. Now, just hang with me. This ain't about religion. You just got to hang with me. And listen close. this Mandela effect that the people are seeing or experiencing. And when you go in there and do the research, I guarantee you, if your eyes are open, you're gonna have some memories that you have that aren't necessarily the same. Remember Chick-fil-A? It was Chick-fil-A, Chick-fil-A restaurants. Remember that? Well, it's not that. It's Chick. There's a big thing happening here. I want to go into that more, but right now I just want to show you one of the changes that is a serious one. In Scripture, it talks about the Lord's Prayer. You know, everybody knows the Lord's Prayer. There's only two places it shows up. One's in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9. And it talks about there. And there it used to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. You remember that. Okay, and over in Luke, it said pretty much the same. Our Father who art in heaven. But there it said, forgive us our debts as we forgive those who are our debtors. Doesn't say that now. In any Bible in the world, or at least in this reality. And nobody's had access to your Bible. I've got Bibles that nobody's had access. How can that be? You look back into history and everything. It doesn't say that now. Go and read that in Matthew chapter. Go read Matthew chapter 6, verse 9, and read the Lord's Prayer. There's another place. This is for people that would study the Scripture or the ancient texts and things like that. You might get some of it. But what I'm trying to explain is this is proof of the Mandela effect, because you can pick up any Bible. And those of you that know Scripture have got it written in your heart. It says, judge not lest you be judged. It doesn't say that anymore either. It doesn't say judge not. There's a place in Isaiah where it talks about where the lion will lay down with the lamb. Well, they changed that. Now it says the wolf will lay down with the lamb, and the leopard with the young goat. Really. It uses words that are new. Over there in Luke, in chapter 17, the word stuff, if those that were up on their housetops, not to come down and take anything out but to flee. Well, it doesn't say take things out now or your possessions. It says stuff, S-T-U-F-F. Doesn't matter how old your Bible is. Now it says stuff. Every Bible in the world says it all of a sudden. Now this is ridiculously crazy. But I'm telling you, I know my Scripture here. And one of the things is over in Matthew. I wanted to look, but I found proof of it. But I wanted to show you this. You better see this. Given back in November 1966. It's an old, just one of these old family Bibles, you know. Right? Okay, check this out. This is crazy. Over in Matthew. Let me get there and then I'll turn it back on here. This is in Matthew 9 and chapter 17. I want to show you something. This is an old King James Bible. Neither do men put new wine into old bottles, else the bottles break, and the wine runneth out, and the bottles perish. But they put new wine into new bottles, and both are preserved. It didn't say bottles. It said wineskins. Neither do men put new wine into old wineskins. Check this out. Some of the things that have changed, but not everything. I've got this book. This, again, I've got all these books. So it hasn't affected all the books, but this isn't an actual Bible. This is Find It Fast in the Bible. So when you go in here and you look up for the old wineskins, same place I just read to you, Matthew 9:17. It says, nor do people put new wine into old wineskins, or else the wineskins break. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. It says it in Mark 2:22. No one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else the new wine bursts with the wineskins. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. Mark 2:22. Let's look that one up in here real quick. Mark 2:22. Let's see. Mark 2:22. Look at this. And no man putteth new wine into old bottles, else the new wine doth burst, the bottles, and the wine is spilled. They didn't have bottles then. It would have been the wineskins. And there's other places that this has changed. They haven't changed every book and advertisements. They haven't changed. This is where you call me crazy, and that's fine. But people that know these scriptures that are written in their heart, you can see if you study this Mandela effect and see what's going on. All of the things. Remember the mirror, mirror on the wall, or the different movie lines that have been spoken. The baseball thing says, we build it and they will come. It doesn't say that now. You go watch any version of it. It says, when you build it, he will come. Some strange things, all these little changes, little words, little letterings, the Berenstain Bears. You go in there and look, everybody remembers the E on it. I remember that because I said Berenstain, and my dad, he said, well, it's spelt like Berenstain. My dad's passed away now a long time, but Berenstain, and he said, it should like Frankenstein. And I said, no, it's Berenstain. That's the way it was. I used to get their comic books. It's Berenstain. Now everything says Berenstain, S-T-A-I-N. All these little changes that so many people are aware of. Now, again, a certain age bracket, it cuts off. They don't know the difference. They haven't experienced it. And people say, oh, it's just your memory. Look, one thing I got down pat, another scripture, and I got enough books to back it up. I mean, this one hadn't been changed yet. And the things that they're changing out there to try and manufacture. But it's a mind boggle when you know the scripture, the lion laying down with the lamb, now it says wolf. Go look in your Bible and check that out over there in Isaiah. I mean, I'm telling you, the things have changed. A new dimension to port. This is all about CERN. I'm trying to explain that. Okay, I'm just going to throw that out there to you. Look into the Mandela effect. And for those of you that are Bible lookers and things like that, if there was ever some delusion on the earth right now, you need to go look, because now your memories aren't what they once were. And I'm telling you, it applies to so many things. So many things that people aren't even aware of. Everything from geological. There's people talking about they used to have to take the ferry over to Staten Island up there. But there's a bridge there now. Most people don't even know or didn't even remember. People living right there in New York didn't know that bridge was there, but it's there. Crazy things, man. There's a great thing happening. But here's what bothers me. Because there's a lot more changes in that Bible. A lot of them. And it doesn't matter what Bible you go, the one I normally will read out of, doesn't matter which one you look at. And how many other books have been changed, the words and lettering, and how they've done it. This is that great delusion, that great deception that's coming upon the earth. There's something happening here, and it is a mind boggle. Now, I mean, we're talking a walk through the twilight zone. It's amazing. It's an amazing time. They're calling it enlightenment, maybe, or the awakening, or something like that. But I'm telling you, what they're doing at CERN, and I've got proof on that. I've been trying to work on getting a video to you. I want to get you that. And if I'm alive long enough and I can pull all this off, I'll try to. But I'm telling you, those of you that know your Bible, that know the word was trespasses, it ain't there now. Now the trespasses words down there in Matthew on the Lord's Prayer is down below that. So they just changed it to debt and debtor, and the Matthew one was the trespasses. So after you read on down, then they use the word trespasses there. It's just crazy. It's crazy. But listen, don't be disheartened. When you get in there, those that are reading their Bibles and stuff like that, that know these scriptures by heart, when you get in there and see these things, don't let it boggle your mind that the changes have been made that way. But I'm telling you, there's not a Bible on the earth, at least not in this reality, not in this dimension. They did it. They've succeeded at what they were trying to do. And that may just be the first run or the first couple of runs. There's more coming. And it's going to get crazy. It's going to get crazy. I'm telling you. But you got to hear what this is facts. This isn't no conspiracy theory. Go look in any Bible now and see. All those that knew, I mean, how many kids grew up? Even if you're atheist, a lot of them grew up with the idea they knew the Lord's Prayer, for goodness sakes. It's changed. There's other things changed in there too, some key ones. Y'all go check his stuff out, man. It's crazy. One last thing. I'm going to leave some links on the bottom. Some other videos that have been put out that will explain the Mandela effect, or people that are having the same experiences. And there's some that you can go and test yourself and see where your memory lies. T- to see what exists in your head right now, because I mean, this is some crazy stuff. It does. It makes you think, am I losing my mind? And I know good and well I'm not, because there's some things you know in your heart, and you know for a fact, beyond a shadow of a doubt. Your young memory, your long-term memory, is stronger and works better than your short-term memory. But I wrote a lot of it off, like the Fruit Loops and the Looney Tunes and all these different things. They were talking about the changes on the different names. I figured, you know, well, it's new marketing, new age, you know, everything changes as it goes. But look, how that every one of the Bibles in my house has changed within days is an impossibility. And yet it is. Look in yours. You'll see what I'm talking about. So I'll leave you some links to check out some of this stuff. The Mandela Effect. Then you can find out what's really going on at CERN. I'll try and get a video out explaining all of it, because there's just so much. It's just crazy. It's crazy. Y'all, don't get too worried about it. Don't let it overwhelm you, because it's like a walk through the twilight zone. This is truly a walk down into a rabbit hole. Hang tough. Wanted to add this on too. This is a 1611, the Old English style. Over in Luke chapter... what chapters are these? I never give Roman numerals. DC 17, I guess it's 17. Yeah, chapter 17, that's right. In chapter 17, and this is the Old English now, the original 1611 edition, right? And even here it says, in that day, let's see, shall be upon the housetop and his stuff in the house. S-T-U-F-F-E. Really? In that one, it even changed and put stuff there in the Old English. Now, watch this. Check this out. Talking about in the New King James Version, okay? I wanted to check there too, just to be certain, right? And three, where we're talking about the wineskins. Now, this is crazy, because here it said bottles before. In the new one, the Revised Version, or the New King James, it says, nor do they put new wine into old wineskins, or else the wineskins break, the wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. But they put new wine into new wineskins, and both are preserved. Now, the Lord's Prayer we was talking about, that's still the same in the old or the new. But it's different, it's flipped, because the old one, the original ones, had the wineskins. And now it says bottles in the original King James Version. You have to check. If you're in the New King James Version, now it says wineskins where it said bottles before. And so, again, if you go over there to chapter 6 and verse 9, let's see, I'm trying to see here on this. Bear with me. 6. That's why I don't like these new ones, but I keep them. I've got New Revised International Editions and all of them, but I go by the original. That's why I prefer. But here we go. It was in chapter 6. We was talking about verse 9. And he's talking about, it says, therefore do not be always, it's in verse 9, in this manner therefore pray, our Father who art in heaven, it just says our Father in heaven, this is the new one, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done. It was thy in the old, on earth as it is in heaven. That was the right part. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Now again, this was the one that was in Luke originally, but now it's in Matthew. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil, from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Now that's in the new version. But again, in the original, it was, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Remember, forgive us our trespasses. So anyway, y'all go look it all up. Have fun with it. Welcome to the Twilight Zone.
Really? Please.
make a quick video here, sort of in regards to the last one that I put out. This is important. Those of you that know me know I have a tendency to bounce around a lot, but I'm asking you right now, and if you're new, just hang in there with me a minute. But I wanted to talk to you briefly, and again, I want to touch a lot of subjects as fast as I possibly can. This is going to sound foreign to very many of you, I would imagine. But just bear with me. This is so important, and it's a lot to try and wrap your mind around. It really is.
Now, physicists claim to have combined the two to create a magnetic wormhole that works as a cloaking device. The device creates a spherical wormhole that causes a magnetic field applied at one end to appear at the other, as if it's coming out of nowhere. Not being a wormhole in the sense of being a tunnel through the fabric of space and time, the technology creates the illusion of being a portal for magnetic fields.
But for those with eyes to see and ears to hear, those that are empathetic and have the ability to perhaps understand or grasp the scope of how big this reality is here that I want to touch on. Again, just you got to bear with me. Okay, so I'm going to bounce around. I've got some clips I want to show you. This is I'm working on a video. I'm working with old equipment at this point in the game, and it takes a bit to upload stuff, but I'm working on it. But I need to touch on these topics. You need to be aware of this. It's so important, and I guarantee you that this information will affect your life regardless of who you are or where you are. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about that. This will affect you. I guarantee it. But trust no man. Don't trust me. Don't take my word for anything. Do your own research and go and look and see what I'm saying is true or not. But there's this phenomenon that's going on, and many people have noticed it. A lot of it's getting wrote off as just coincidence, or that people have bad memories all of a sudden, and things that you thought that were, come to find out aren't. And everything from books you've read to movies you've seen to even places you've been. So much that's taking place right now. But you've got to understand the reasons for this. Now, I'm still working on this video that will explain all of these things. God willing, and I survived long enough to get it out. I've been working on it for a couple of weeks. I'm having to just throw stuff together at this point. Again, glitches and different things. It's an interesting word, glitches. Words to be familiar with is symmetry and supersymmetry and things like that, to understand what that's about. I know, now here we go. I'm already sounding like a crazy guy in the woods, right? But what I'm asking you really is to just hang with me for a few minutes and let me share a couple of things with you. And you've got to look at this with an open mind. Pretend I'm just some crazy entertainment show and you're just watching it, or some sci-fi movie. But everything that I'm telling you is real and verifiable. You can check it out on your own. That's the whole point. What I'm telling you is going to sound science fiction. It's way out there. Twilight Zone stuff, I've said before. And this is real. This is the problem. Because it's real. It's just crazy. Okay, so
you do better when I'm walking.
But the stuff I gotta tell you is really serious. Okay, you gotta hear me. You gotta hear me. People are having issues all over the globe now. It's not just in America. This is everywhere. If you just look into it, I know it's hard for a lot of people because you don't speak all the different languages, but it's happening across the whole entire earth. I'm gonna put some links to a few different videos. On this one as well. I did a few links on my last video to give some people some understanding there, perhaps, or some in-depth. And I'm going to put some links on this one. Again, this is stuff so you can verify what I'm telling you and check it out for yourself so that you can have proof in your own gut. It's important that you have that for yourself, not to take somebody else's word, but to do some research. Most people are too, I don't mean to sound rude, but most people are too lazy or don't have the time even to really dig and do the kind of research that is necessary perhaps to understand some of these things. But people everywhere are having issues. And I mean, again, all across the world, and you've probably experienced it already. If you haven't, I'm sure you will. This thing called the Mandela Effect. A lot of people are writing it off as, oh, well, that's just some glitch in the matrix. You hear that a lot. A glitch in the matrix. It's more to it than just that. And what's really being done that's causing it is what's happening through the CERN facility. And I'm going to try and do that video. I'm working on it, y'all. You just have to bear with me on that. But the glitch is where people are having different issues. Remember back when Nelson Mandela died? He was in prison. Remember that? Well, evidently that didn't happen because he didn't die until 2013. And he didn't die in prison. He got out and became the president of Africa somewhere. I know, that's boggling just to some. And there's a lot of different ones if you just look in. Mandela Effect, I'm telling you. Hey, this is crazy. Just had my wife Google Muhammad Ali. This is born, this is Googled. So when it shows it right here, supposedly a web page or whatever for him. It says Muhammad Ali's Twitter 7 hours ago. This is Muhammad Ali. Today is May the 18th, 2016, just so you understand this. Okay? Muhammad Ali, American president, Louisville, Kentucky. It says born January 17th, 1942, age 74. Okay? I know. I'm just keep... You'll understand what I'm showing you. Okay, over here. Muhammad Ali dies at age 71. He died 3 years ago with Parkinson's disease. This is not a joke. This is real. This is published February 3rd, 2013. Boxing legend Muhammad Ali dies 71 from Parkinson's disease. I appreciate this video being used as a memorial page. There's other things where he died. This is a part of that effect. If you look it up, this is R.I.P. Muhammad Ali. Please use this video as a memorial page for legend. I know somebody did this as a YouTube, so you're automatically going to say this is crazy and all this and that, or this is fake. Somebody's YouTube. Just go look it out for yourself. But if you Google Muhammad Ali, 3 years ago he died at 71. Now it's saying here 3 years later he's 74 years old and not dead at all. Somebody said Jim Nabors is alive. Jim Nabors died, oh, back, what, 2000-something maybe, with throat cancer. They were saying possibly due to AIDS. And now we're finding out that he is alive and just got married when they legalized gay marriage. And Jim Nabors used to be Gomer Pyle on the Andy Griffith Show. This is crazy to me. Muhammad Ali died 3 years ago. I know that. Do you remember Muhammad Ali dying? I'm looking for more stuff to show where he died, because everybody was reporting on it. But now we're finding out he's not dead yet. On YouTube, Muhammad Ali dies. It says Muhammad Ali dies, age 71. This was 3 years ago. Here it says Muhammad Ali, life after death. 2 years ago, the death of a boxer legend, Muhammad Ali. He was at the funeral of Joe Frazier. Be watching, Joe Frazier may pop up. Who knows? This is sort of crazy. Muhammad Ali's daughter revealed intimate details about their dad. Muhammad Ali has died. Oh, rest in peace. 3 years ago. He died 3 years ago, y'all, back in 2013. Muhammad Ali on deathbed. So his brother could be dead in days. This is just YouTube. Let's see. Death of the greatest, Muhammad Ali. I mean, it's just, everybody was reporting on it. And yet, when you go over here and you Google it, Google Muhammad Ali, now it says he's 74. But he didn't die 3 years ago. Evidently, he's just aged 3 years and is still around now. I remember when he died. Don't y'all remember that? Does anybody remember this?
But one of the weirdest ones that got me was Louis Anderson, right? I thought Louis Anderson died, but obviously Louis Anderson is alive and catting off.
Channing, you remember when she died? No, you don't. She's 95. According to the Google. When you Google these people. Doris Day. 92. I actually thought she had passed away, but that's just me. And CERN, everybody's heard all this and that. But there's this effect that's really going on, that's taking place. And things in our reality are changing. And it's real. It's real. This is why it seems so bizarre. But anybody that's awake, who are taking notice of these things and know in their gut and know in their mind that this is all real, are being made out to look like they're crazy. And we know we're not. And they're saying we've jumped dimensions and things like that. You'll hear that a lot. And that's not exactly correct. But something's been unleashed, as it were, that's causing a ripple effect through what we know as time. There's an old prophecy or scripture way back. Now again, this is going to affect everybody. It doesn't matter what you believe as far as your belief systems. But this glitch, as it were, that is causing a time change, and it's interesting. The old prophecy said that they would think to change the times and the law, and that's sort of what we're seeing the beginning of. This is the beginning of a great deception that was prophesied so long ago, and it is so bizarre that even the very elect may be deceived if it were possible. What is setting up right now is probably and the last video I did, as well as this one and the one I'm hoping to do next, God willing, and I have breath and life and success to prove how this is working and why. And it sounds, I'm probably just sounding like I'm rambling. Listen, just bear with me. I'm going to show you a bunch of different things here real quick. And I'm going to have to bounce around so much because there's so much to cover. That's the problem. There's just so much to cover. But these things are real, and to wrap your mind around what is happening is it's disturbing, because most people can't do it. You can see the things, and everyone wants to scientifically write everything off or explain everything away. And there is some science to it, sure enough, coding and decoding of the genomes and the DNA structures and all kinds of stuff, and particle acceleration and all of that. And it includes magic too. And there, you want to shut off right there real quick, but you got to hang with me because it's not a good thing, but it's real. So bear with me. Let me show you a couple examples real quick of what I'm talking about. And again, this is just a follow-up video of the last one I did. I really want you to watch that last video, at least for those of you that are Christians and know your Bibles and things like that. There is a phenomenon that's taking place, and you've heard of Berenstain Bears and the Berenstain Bears. Surely you've looked into this, but if you haven't, it's the Mandela Effect. And why it's so important is because it is foretold already, and things that are changing are to set you up, and that's it's a dangerous thing. It really is. It really is. Man has overstepped some boundaries in a realm they shouldn't be messing with, but it was all foretold. So just bear with me. Okay, so I told you I was going to bounce around a lot. Back when my grandmother passed away, she was in her 80s, and she had some issues, and she passed away. Well, some of the things that was hers was passed on to my mother and then to me as well. And one of those things was a pack of Depends. I just said, don't throw them out because you never know, somewhere down the road somebody may need them, or we may need them, or whatever. Who knows? You know, Depends are adult diapers. Okay? And basically, you know, for the older generations that have bladder problems and things like that. Well, Depends has been on the market for a long time. Now, it says Depends. Everybody knows Depends. I mean, it's been around so long. But I had seen about the Mandela Effect and how letters were changed so that you would understand that. So anyway, I had my wife, we'd put some here in this in the bathroom, in this bench. And I said, I got to see this for myself. When I put it in here, it was just a regular pack of Depends, what was left. And so we took a look at it. Okay, so understand, in here, Depends that we had put in into this thing. So my grandmother had needed them or used them. And when we put it in there, it said Depends. Okay? But it's D-E-P-E-N-D. Nowhere, anywhere can you find that it ever said Depends. Even the old commercials have changed. Now, I know that's impossible, but when I put this in here, in this bench, it said Depends with an S. That S is gone. Tell me how that's possible. But there it is. A black lab, so we're users of Febreze. Febreze used to be F-E-B-R-E-E-Z-E. Febreze, you know, like a breeze of fresh air. Remember that? Febreze. F-R-E-B-R-E-E-Z-E. Now, it's an E missing. Impossible. Chick-fil-A, I mentioned that in the last video. I urge you to go watch the last video I did. It used to be C-H-I-C. We used to joke about it being chic. You know, what are they trying to be cool, like chick jeans, chic? But it's C-H-I-C-K, filet. Sara Lee bought Sara Lee Old Fashioned Bread. The Sara Lee motto was, nobody does it like Sara Lee. And now it says, nobody doesn't like Sara Lee. It's just little changes, a letter here, a word there, Jif. Some people said it used to be Jiffy. I don't know. It seems like it might have been Jiffy at one time. Not sure on the peanut butter, to be honest. See? Already our memories are slipping. Thing here. You remember the thing? This is chicken breast. But you remember the old song from childhood? It says, my baloney had a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R. My baloney had a second name. It's G-M-E-Y-E-R.
Oh, I love to eat it every day, and if you ask me, well, I'll say, 'cause Oscar Mayer has a way with B-O-L-O-G-N-A. Oscar Mayer is Oscar Mayer. Tell me how. Do you remember Mayer? Are you awake yet? It's bizarre. Welcome to the Twilight Zone.
Before Berenstain Bears. Look into that. That'll get you started on everything. Used to be Berenstain. But now, that letter is an E, or no, is an A. And that's everywhere. Even the authors are Berenstain. But you can look and find out that that was changed too. There's proof out there. Just gotta look for it. Just gotta look for it. And again, the Lord's Prayer. It doesn't matter which one you look into. It's a lot about these kinds of things and what they're doing. You just have to check it out. Okay, one more. Even on your maps, whether it be on a round map or a flat map, on the globes, remember how South America used to be more down this way? Look how much further over it is. It's almost out in front of that altogether. And Australia seems to have moved up on the globe or something, you know. Look at that, it's almost touching this. Remember, it was an island off by itself? I mean, I know that sounds crazy, but if you know anything about geography, then this is one that will stand out in your mind. But the whole South American continent seems to have shifted over. And it doesn't matter, like I said, whether you use it in the round or the old. I mean, I know those that know geography. Look how much further over South America is on there. Look on a flat map and see what I'm talking about. This used to be straight down. Remember how this seemed to come down this way? I know it sounds science crazy. I told you it would. But now it's got more elongated. Check this out. Remember Italy being the boot? Look at Italy. In here on the boot. Oh, I don't even know if it's going to focus or not. Will it focus? Come on. Well, go look at it on a map. Italy now is connected to Sicily and stuff right there. It's sort of a crazy thing. Even on the globes here, where Italy was by itself, that little boot, that's how we all know or knew Italy, if you remember. And now the boot is not getting close to kicking. It's connected. Do you remember that? Do you? And check this out. It doesn't matter. Even if you go back to the old ones, look how far over, even on the old ones, South America is way over there. This here is like somebody has taken this and shifted it over a little bit. I know it sounds crazy, but if you know geology, or geography rather, you'll know that's a fact. Telling you, crazy stuff. So you know, for centuries they've drawn circles on the ground and that kind of stuff to create magic and things with the dark side. You know, you see even in your movies and stuff, they'll draw a real big circle on the ground. I don't know if you can see it. They'll draw a big circle on the ground and make letters and different things in it, you know, the ancient Sanskrit and different Hebrew texts and different words, and usually trying to use like the ancient holy names of God and things like that. And they've done that for centuries. I mean, that's the old ancient witchcraft, the Luciferians, the Druids, all of that stuff, Wiccan, all of it. And I'm hoping to show all of this stuff, explain it all in depth in this other video. But anyway, they've done this for a long time. And the idea is to draw a circle that they would get inside of and protect them, and it creates an energy, and it opens portals and doors and things like that. And this is how they're doing it. Well, it gets into some dark stuff. Usually your people that are on a Christian side of life try and stay away from that kind of information because it gets really dark. And those that are on the dark side have a tendency to stay away from the biblical aspects of things. And so, without looking at each other's sides, as it were, so much is missed and just slides right by. But you can look in any Bible and what used to be in the Lord's Prayer, Father, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. I cover this in the last video. I really want you to watch that. But that's not in your Bible no more. It doesn't matter if you're in the New Revised Version or the original King James. The Lord's Prayer no longer says, and ask any Catholic, they usually know it by heart, you know, from birth. I mean, most people do. But it doesn't say, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. It used to. But now even the words in that are changed. And most of your concordance, any biblical references, but there's different books that haven't been changed. That's something to look into. Crazy stuff, y'all. Crazy stuff. And it's hard to wrap your mind around it because it seems impossible. But it ain't.
It is based on a theoretical design to create a wormhole for electromagnetic waves proposed in 2007 that would create an invisible tunnel between two points. The researchers used magnetic metamaterials and metasurfaces designed specifically to have properties not found in nature to create a working model of the wormhole.
Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Well, that's not in your Bible now, all of a sudden. And you can look at the one you've been looking at for however long you've been looking at them. It doesn't matter what one you pick up at this point. This is a part of that grand deception, the grand delusion that's coming on, as well as all these other things. But if they can change letters in one place, they can change them in another, and they can show it as historical. Just like the Sara Lee. Look into that one. Nobody does it like Sara Lee. And now they say with a double negative, nobody doesn't like Sara Lee. It doesn't even make sense, actually. But I'm telling you, this is real. And you need to make everybody aware because this is going to affect your life. Because they're going to make you look like a crazy person. Pretty much like I look like right now, I guess. But hey, listen, it's Photo Helix. Trying to be a watchman for you. But if you don't take heed, well, that's all on your own shoulders right there. I'm just trying to throw out some information. I don't care. I heard a guy say, I ain't trying to impress CNN. I ain't no reporter. I'm just some guy with an opinion on YouTube. That's all. So don't let it fret you. Don't debate about it. There's nothing to debate. There's no conspiracy theory. Honest to goodness, there really isn't. You'll see that in the next video, Lord willing, I get to put one out. But what you can physically put your hands on and touch and know for a fact in reality. Reality is stranger than fiction. I'm on my rooftop and I'm shouting it from the rooftop. This is all real. The largest circle on the earth. You know, I was telling you about the magic circles where they're drawing things up. Calling things forth, opening doorways, in their own words, dimensional openings. Largest circle on the earth is 17 miles in diameter, and it's located in a place in the ancients was considered the location for the gates of hell. That's CERN. I hope to touch on it and show you and explain all that in detail. But listen. I'm up on my rooftop, and I'm shouting it out from the rooftop this time. Watchmen on the wall, watchmen underground, watchmen on the roof. Seriously. It's going to affect us all. Things are strange. Stranger than fiction. Truth is. So you better get ready. Pay attention. Be sharp. Be alert. You better be prayed up. Watch my other video, the one I did before this. Those of you that are Bible thumpers, you know what I mean. Keep us in your prayers. And, hey, you need to tell everybody. Might make you sound crazy, but everybody, when they start having the experiences and see, their eyes get opened up, you'll see. I'm not asking you to get on your roof and holler it out, but, hey, help me. Share this if you don't care. Pass it around. I don't make a dime off of it. Never have. Never will. don't intend to, but I don't do Facebook and all those other things either, so this is it. So if this gets taken out or wiped out or whatever, so copy it as you will, feel free to use it however, and share it with people, let them know. I'm telling you, this is real. Remember, we battle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and spirits, evil and high places. Y'all get ready. There's some rough things coming. Been telling you. Now you're going to see. Photo Helix. I'm out.
Okay, Vito Corleone looking at the Statue of Liberty on Ellis Island. Although now everybody knows, no, it was never Ellis Island, right? The Statue of Liberty was on, it's on right now, Liberty Island. Okay, and then I went to the antique store, found this old postcard. It's probably, I don't know, 70 years old. I think it's from like the 50s or something. Very old. I go in the back, and what's it say? Statue of Liberty, Bedloe's Island? Can the real island please step forward? This 300-foot statue illuminates the gateway to the New World. Don't know about you guys, but I'm thoroughly confused about what island Statue of Liberty is on.
I discovered the Mandela Effect by innocently noticing Fruit Loops in the grocery store spelled Fruit Loops, F-R-O-O-T. I didn't think anything was peculiar at the time. I believed it was just a marketing rebranding, which happens sometimes. But later that same night, I noticed someone on YouTube posted a video about Fruit Loops. I thought that was strange, so I watched the video. After watching the video, a cascading investigating event ensued. I found that this Mandela effect was not isolated to just one thing or event. I found changes in historic events, movie titles, and iconic lines within movies changed. The Bible changed, landmasses changed, populations changed, and time has sped up. I didn't sleep for 3 days straight initially as I lay in a fetal position in one of my spare rooms of my Fort Wainwright, Alaska, on post house. We had recently lost our daughter to cancer, so my wife was already isolating herself, and this was not something I could add to her already desperate period of adjustment. I too felt our daughter's loss, and now I have noticed the world is not what I thought it was, or not what I was taught it was from the beginning. What is this Mandela effect? Have I shifted realities? Did the world blow up and we're all in a parallel dimension? Does God have a message in this whole thing? Does this prove or disprove God himself? I searched, alone, these and even more possibilities. My search ended after I decided to do the one thing I should have done at the very first sighting of this grand event. I prayed, and I asked God what was going on. My struggle slowed, and I waited. I prayed this request repeatedly for several weeks. I received my answer at the appointed time and place of God's choosing in a dream I experienced while asleep in Saudi Arabia. I walked calmly to a tall white tower with no windows. The tower was most likely 7 to 10 stories tall. There was a single opening in the front, no door, just an opening where a door could be. I walked in and observed stairs lining the walls all the way to the top, like you would see in a lighthouse. The inside was brightly lit, but not from an observable light source. The walls and stairs just gave their own light. I could only hear my footsteps as I walked to the top of the tower. I didn't feel fear or really any emotion other than curiosity of what was at the very top of this tall white tower. When I reached the top, there was a white floored platform, and at the top of the stairs on the flat banister rail sat a large brown Bible with a gold cross. The cross was the size of the Bible itself. I had never seen this Bible before and I didn't recognize it. I picked it up to read it, and as I opened the book, I noticed that the pages were all blank. White, with no ink at all. I flipped through the pages and they were all blank. As I searched the Bible, I heard a loud growl from behind me. I knew that if I didn't leave, that what was behind me would destroy me. I said to myself, uh-oh, and then I ran down the stairs, feeling this angry beast right on my heels the whole time. If I slowed down, I was gonna get hit. I could hear the breathing of this beast behind me, and feel the wind from the swings of what might have been a claw of some sort. I didn't slow down to look at what was behind me. I raced down the stairs and out the front opening and into an awakened state in my bed. From that point forward, I was no longer questioning what this Mandela effect is or will be. I am now an awakened saint.
Why is the Mandela effect happening more in the KJV than in the NIV? Something weird to me. So my man, I think his name is Rocco, he posted on my thing that, this was not in the Bible where men had milk in their breasts. No way. And that's in the KJV now, where men have milk in their breasts. And if I can't, off the top of my head, I can't remember, but I think I went and I looked in the NIV and it didn't say that. And then Rocco said he had been reading the KJV since 2008 pretty religiously. I guess he had gone through a come to Jesus moment. And all of a sudden in 2018, 10 years later, in Luke 6:2, it said Jesus was going through a field of corn. And Rocco said he about fell off his chair because corn in the Middle East. 2,000 years ago. Yeah, no. And so I went and looked at the NIV, and it was still grain fields. It wasn't corn fields. And this seems to be happening a lot with the KJV being subject to the Mandela effect. And I haven't even bothered with a Catholic Bible. I haven't looked. But, you know, that's just weird to me. The only thing I could possibly think is, and this is literally, do not be offended by this, because I'm just throwing it out there, but it's interesting to me, is maybe the KJV is more devout readers, you know what I'm saying? Because they're more, like, if you see the comments when I talk about the Mandela effect and the reality shifts in the Bible, people literally get mad. It's like, how dare you, the KJV would never change, it's the word of God, all that stuff. I just wonder if the KJV is a more devout, I hate to say legalistic because it sounds like I'm demeaning these people. I'm not in the least, man. I'm not. Do not take an insult from this. I just think the more devout, legalist, that's not what I'm trying to say. But just the more devout. I don't know what else to say, man. And I don't mean that people who read the NIV are not devout. I'm not saying anything like that. I'm just trying to position it that maybe the Mandela effect is taking place because the KJV adherents are more thorough, more, I don't know, you know what I'm saying. And as such, when they have the changes, the impacts them because they're so thorough and devout to the KJV that they say this could never happen. And yet they'll go and say men breasts did have milk. It says it in the Bible, if that makes sense. It's divide and conquer. I don't know else to say it, man. And yet the NIV doesn't have that like that. I don't know why. It's interesting to me. Now, my man Dan, who's a devout guy, he's like, so what does this mean that we don't listen to the word of the God and the word of God? I said, man, no. not in the least. I've become more devout with my relationship with God. I am still a sinner. I'm just telling you right now, since I've started to see a different reality exist, i.e. the idea that we went to the moon, for instance. It's silly to me now. The Mandela effects, recognizing that God is not the Bible. God is beyond all things. The words written by men are not God. Now, that might be God's words, I grant you. But it's words on a page are not God, if that makes sense. God is so far above all these things. My respect, my love of God, my friends, has grown so much in the last couple of years since I've started to discover an alternative reality. And that sounds like, oh, you're living in a false world. No, it's like a different world that says that God, the supernatural is of God is so, it's so amazing. And this has been nothing but a wonderful journey for me of how God is so vast. He can't just be put in a book. And I've said this before, but Andy Stanley down here at North Point Community Church, I think he said it best. He goes, look, God is not a vending machine. You don't just put a quarter in and, you know, get a Snickers bar. God is, it's amazing to me, actually. My love and faith in God has grown so much over these last couple of years. And I none of this to say, oh, well, the God's word is being challenged. It's words on paper, man. God isn't being challenged. God himself is. And this is, again, going back to the whole thing where when you start to challenge this stuff, like the moon landing and other things, or the idea that Polaris is, it used to be, you know, 3,000 trillion miles away. Now it's just 2,000 trillion miles away. But somehow we're still able to see it up there every year or every night. And we can navigate by it, even though we're spinning at, you know, 60,000 miles an hour around the sun, or we're rotating 1,000 miles an hour, so we can change the days and all that. On top of the sun is spinning, on top of the galaxy, all this stuff. It's just so freaking silly that you recognize that we've been sold a bill of goods to diminish, to make us diminutive, whatever that word is, small. And the reason they do this is anti-God. Literally, I think so. It's like they're going to make us so small that the universe is so big. Why would God, if God, like literally, it's making God small. God is, he wants a personal relationship with us, but we are just specks of sand on a beach. Why? So that just shows how small God, the universe is bigger than God is what they would say. And then you start thinking, wait a second, that's, you know, you're saying, well, your God is small. Why? Because you're on earth and you're nothing. You're nothing. You're irrelevant. And I could easily see how people fall for that. Easily. People say, oh man, yeah, the universe is so big. God, why would God want a relationship with me? I'm just nothing. I'm irrelevant. And you start thinking, wait a second, man. Polaris is 3,000 trillion miles away. And just like that, with a snap of the finger, in 10 years' time, it went from 3,000 trillion miles away to 2,000 trillion miles away. And yet somehow we're still able to navigate it by it, even with our vast spinning and rotating. And you're like, yeah, that doesn't make any sense, man. And don't even start with me on relativity. You're like, that doesn't make any sense. So how do you explain this? And you can't, man. It's just silly. So what I would say now, and I haven't said this before, it didn't really bother me that much because I always loved God. But what I say now is that I think you're missing this, the supernatural of what God wants for us. You know what I'm saying? I think you're putting the universe above us. And God didn't do that. God put us above everything else. Other than, you know, the supernatural, him, you know what I'm saying? And that's, I think we need to reaffirm humanity is what matters in God's eyes. You know what I'm saying? Humanity. And recognize that we are God's chosen people, chosen beings. I don't know why. Are there other things out there? Maybe. I don't know. How do I not know that? Well, I'd look at what God's words in the Bible says to lead me and to guide me. But I think you can't just, well, I don't want to say you can't just do that. I just think at the end of the day, though, you say, well, God's words in the Bible are wonderful, but the most wonderful thing is my antenna, my brain, and my heart, and my discussions with God, and my prayers. We just got to pray more, man. Jesus prays so much. You ever notice that? Does that lead you to something? Yeah. Is in the Bible, Joshua, saying the Bible's changed? I'm saying the Bible, parts of the Bible have changed. Yes. But that doesn't mean there's not a quality info in there. It's still Jesus prays, man, more than anything. Jesus doesn't pick up a book. He prays all the time. And I just think we don't do that. I know I didn't. Just pray. Pray and pray and pray. And that's where God's guidance will be, in my opinion. I could be wrong. I might change my mind. I don't know. I just sit there and thinking, man. Don't just, you gotta hear, again, I think our brain is antenna to God. God's talking to us, hits our brain, it goes to our heart. But you have to talk to God to get that. And you need to pray. And that's where I think ultimately for me, what's coming down is I'm praying more and more. And I just like, dudes, I can't tell you how liberating it is to be reborn, literally, well, not literally, but emotionally reborn to know that, man, I'm back, baby. I'm back. Humanity needs to come back. But I can't control humanity. I can control me. And my humanity is such that God put me on a pedestal. He put you on a pedestal for importance. Don't discount that. All right. Anyway, got to go in here. It's our anniversary today. Got to get some flowers for the beautiful. All right. God bless. We'll see you.
So many people truly aren't aware of what's going on all around them and the times that we are really living in.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one?
No, I am the father. The lion will lie down with the lamb.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb.
What does Forrest Gump say about chocolates? Now in the present reality, it says life was like a box of chocolates.
Life was like a box of chocolates. Life was like a box of chocolates.
The world was on fire. No one could save me by you. Strange what desire will make foolish people do. I never dreamed that I was somebody like you.
Also shall dwell in the land.
This way, what a wicked thing to do, to make me
no,
dream of
I
you.
Am the father.
What a wicked game to play. You never felt this way. What a wicked thing to do, to let me dream.
I could eat about 1.5 million of these. My mom always said life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get.
Limited in a way by having a very low IQ. but he's a very decent man. And that's what he is as a character.
Would you like a chocolate?
Oh, thank you.
I found the book Forrest Gump in 1985. And I fell in love with it. I read the first line. And the first line of the book is, being an idiot ain't no box of chocolates.
Life was like a box of chocolates. Life is like a box of chocolates.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
Life is like a box of chocolates. Life is like a box of chocolates. Life is like a box of chocolates.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
Life is like a box of chocolates.
You never know what you're going to get. Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father.
He told me enough. He told me you killed him.
No. I am your father.
When I first saw the dialogue that said, Luke, I am your father.
No. I am your father.
That said, Luke, I am your father.
No. I am your father.
I said to myself, he's lying. He's lying.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one?
Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not.
Life is like a box of chocolates. Life was like Life was like a box of chocolates.
If you only knew the power of the dark side, Obi-Wan never told you what happened to your father.
He told me enough! He told me you killed him.
No, I am your father. If you only knew the power of the dark side, no, I am your father.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of
Thank you.
also shall dwell with the Lamb. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not.
The wheat and the tares, they grow together and they look a lot alike. It's not until the time of the harvest that they're actually cut down and separated. For a complete understanding of the wheat and the tares, you're going to want to read Matthew chapter 13. Read the whole chapter. It touches on that in a couple of spots. But you need to understand what the wheat and the tares is really about. They'll grow together until harvest time. So many people truly aren't aware of what's going on all around them and the times that we are really living in. The things in this world are disturbing, to say the least. But those that are awake, those that truly know, those that have been buried in their word and in their scriptures, they know these things, they see these things. And those of you that have the ability to see changes in your world around you, you've been given that opportunity to see, and you need to get yourselves right with God. You need to call upon Yeshua. And it's not about a religious thing. It's not religion at all. It's about having a relationship with your Creator. We're running out of time, folks. This artificial intelligence and the things that they're doing and that they're setting up is that great beast system. It is time to get your head out of the dirt and look around and see what's really taking place and realize the times that we are in. This is serious. You need to read Romans 1, the chapter, and 2. Chapters 1 and 2 of Romans. And I'm telling you, so many people, they're worshiping the creation more than the Creator. And that's where you're failing. That's why you can't see. Those of you that have been given a glimpse and you know something's wrong, you need to get right. You need to make your way right with Him. But I'm telling you, people are more embedded in the creation than they are in knowing the Creator. And until you know the Creator, and there's only one way to get there, you got to go through Yeshua. You got to believe on Him. John 3:16, in the King James Version, John 3:16 said, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Yeah, John 3:16, now in the King James Version says, "should not perish, but have everlasting life." You can look at it. But it did say, "shall not perish." Shall not, more of a command. You shall do this, or you shall not do that. Should, well, you shouldn't play in traffic. You should not, but you can. You should not perish, but you might. In John 3:16 originally, and you can see the residue if you go look. And in some of the newer translations now it says, "that shall." "But for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." You got to make your way right. You got to make your way right. We're running out of time. You just don't realize it. You just don't understand that you're not guaranteed that breath. You're not guaranteed your heartbeat. And if you've been, I mean, all are called. Many are called, but few are chosen, right? But all are invited. All are invited. But if you're seeing these things, Just like John 3:16, one of the most famous, says, "shall, now, should." That's scary to me. should be to you if you're a true child of God. Yeah, there's those out there that's just going to keep pointing the fingers and, oh, it can't change. That written paper and ink can't change. But the infallible word in the beginning, you know, before books, was in the beginning with God. That is Yeshua. His name in Revelation 19 is the Word of God. If you know Him, the Holy Spirit will lead you into all understanding. You don't have need of any of us teachers or anybody out here talking. Whether you understand what's actually taking place or not, all of these things were foretold. Now that's the truth. And you're running out of time. You're going to wait until it's too late. And unfortunately, you know, for those that are so blinded under this deception, under this delusion that can't see, it's, you know, this is a hard message because they don't want to hear that. Oh, but maybe that division, the tares already growing up with the wheat there. We're just waiting for the harvest time. It may be that those that can't see will never see. And that's a scary thing because all through Scripture, Christ tells us, for those with eyes to see and with ears to hear, I'm telling you, make your way right with God. Repent. Repent. We all fail. We all fall short. We all make mistakes. We all have. And we continuously do. But your time is not guaranteed. Your promise of tomorrow is not real. And if you think it is, then you've deceived yourself already. And if you really know those scriptures, if you really know it, everybody says hoax and it's not real, it can't change. Those people are lying to themselves. They're lying to you. This is ink and paper. This is a part of creation. And because they worship the Creator less than the creation, God said He would turn them over. Read that, Romans 1 and 2. Romans 1 and Romans 2. Read it.
The New Jerusalem will not be built by murder and uprisings. The wisdom of God will fill the land as water fills the sea. The lion will lie down with the lamb. The lion will lie down with the lamb. The lion will lie down with the lamb. There'll be no more killing or destroying. And the voice of weeping shall be heard no more.
Open your eyes.
This will be the most important message I've ever given, as you'll see as we go along here. Please make sure to have your Bibles on hand, especially tonight. Now, you need to know, or I need to remind you, that I studied under Dr. Gene Scott for almost 30 years and have carried on his message for an additional 8 years. And I base my scholarship on Dr. Scott's scholarship and teaching, as well as on my own research and study that I've done independently. First of all, I want to ask the congregation in here and out there and give me a show of hands. You ever heard of the Mandela effect?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Some have, some haven't. I want to tell you in regards to that, and I need to make sure we emphasize this, that you're not losing your mind or going nuts. I want you to answer the next series of questions out loud to lead into this and to start driving this nail home. And then I'll give you the current answer. Number one, what does Snow White and later the Wicked Queen say to the mirror?
Mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's
the fairest? You said, and I think out there you said, mirror, mirror on the wall. You're right, but no longer. Now it says, in the present reality, magic mirror on the wall. Check it out.
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
We know it said mirror, mirror. Right?
Yes, sir.
Not now. Now that may seem trivial or silly, or you may wonder what does that have to do with anything, but you'll see. Be patient and keep following. Number two, what does Forrest Gump say about chocolates?
Life is like a box of chocolates. Life is like a box of chocolates.
You're right. But now in the present reality, it says life was like a box of chocolates.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
But now in the present reality, it says life was like a box of chocolates. We know he said is. And there are many, many more examples of these kinds of changes, for lack of a better term. Number three, most importantly, there's three examples in Scripture. There are more, lots more. One that you may be familiar with, and I hope you are, I know I certainly am, is a part in the New Testament where it says, you can't put new wine in old wineskins. Right?
Yes, sir.
In this reality, it says, you can't put new wine in old bottles. And bottles replaces wineskin. First of all, I don't believe that they used bottles in those days for wine. They may not have even had bottles. They put wine in wineskins. That's why it was called, that's why they called them wineskins. Now, if you want to look this up yourself, you can find it in Matthew 9:17 and Mark 2:21. That's right, in the King James Bible. These issues seem to be specific to the King James Bible, which we teach from. You'll also find it in Luke 5:37. In Isaiah 11, most everybody's familiar with this. They may not know it as Isaiah 11. But the question is, what shall lay down with the lamb?
The lion.
The lion.
The lion shall lay down with the lamb. Now in this reality it says, the wolf shall lay down with the lamb. And again, like I said before, check it out. Now, the lamb associates to Jesus. And the lion, furthermore, associates to Jesus, who is the lion of the tribe of Judah. The wolf usually associates with evil and with Satan, as in the scripture that says, beware of wolves in sheep's clothing. I think we've all heard that. Now, I want you to, along with me, recite the Lord's Prayer out loud. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. We will no longer find that Lord's Prayer in your Bible or in any Bible in this reality. I want you to go with me first to Matthew 6. Well, let's start out in verse 8 to see the lead into this. It says, be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things you have need of before you ask him. After this manner, therefore, pray ye. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth. Now, we know what to say on earth. Now it says in earth, as it is in heaven. Nowhere does it say anything about trespasses, does it?
No.
What is going on? How is it being done? We all know the scripture says, in the end, even the very elect, if possible, will be fooled. We contemporaneously know a great deception is coming. And we have postulated UFOs coming, saying they made us. There is no God. We waited with trepidation because we heard that the CERN machine or device would be turned on to its highest level, looking for the God particle, and saying it could open portals to alternate realities. Most people don't know that CERN has been used many times for several years. Who knows what it's wrought? Now, Satan and his cohorts, from the Illuminati up, would love to change God's word and make him a liar, or to avoid or postpone his, Satan's, destiny, if possible. It is the great deception, altering our reality. Now, some feel that at some point, God will have gathered his little flock and prepared his greater flock and will close the door to salvation and redemption until the great tribulation and the millennium. It may be too late, or becoming too late, for new recruits. Scary. What do we do? Trust your memory. What would you do if all the Bibles in the world were put in a big pile and burned? No more Bibles. None. I would hope you would do what you were taught and what you remember as the truth. That's what we need to do now. Now, I may lose half my congregation over this because it sounds so nutty on the face of it, but it is actually going on. She said, mirror, mirror. He said, life is like a box of chocolates. Scripture said, new wine and old wineskins, not bottles. Also, the Bible says, the lion shall lay down with the lamb, not the wolf. And the Lord's Prayer is what we recited. Now, just remember two things. God's Word is forever settled where?
In heaven.
So whatever word may come across you in front of you, His Word is settled over there in heaven. And also the second thing is to remember that King David said that the truth of God's Word and His laws are written in our hearts. We're not wrong. And that's my message tonight. The question is, what shall lay down with the lamb?
Lion.
The lion shall lay down with the lamb.
Show thee great and mighty things, which thou knowest not.
What a wicked game to play. You never felt this way. What a wicked thing to do, to make me dream of you.
God's Word is forever settled in heaven. The truth of God's laws are written in our hearts.